those officers that are in attendance to support us. I'm obviously not going to do the usual welcome terms of the public. Officers have advised petitioners and applicants not to attend in line with government guidance on congregating a meeting. Nevertheless, there's a few things that we can do. First one is to agree with the minutes of the meeting on the
13th of February.
Thank you. Are they agreed that I sign those minutes?
Yes, agreed, Chair.
Agenda item 2, members code of conduct declarations of interest. Members of the committee asked whether they have any personal prejudicial interest in connection with any application on the agenda of such a declared and state connection of the interest. Any declarations of interest?
Chair, it mentioned obviously there's an application for Maisie there, passes on Maisie Friday. I think it's distant enough not to declare prejudicial interest, but the others may make a connection through Maisie Friday and Maisie Rail, so it'll only be a personal interest. Take part.
Thanks, Chair. It's not a declaration for myself, but I've only been made aware today that item number 7, although it's not listed in the report, is in fact an application in part of the agenda living.
It wasn't possible. Item 7 is it's not possible. I know we scan these very carefully. It's not really possible for me to detect that, but if that is the case, I will say that the prejudicial interest in leave the room in the agenda application. Thanks for that, Ian. Thanks for your
money. Okay, thanks for those questions of interest. As usual, the agenda will be altered. I can advise members that agenda item number 4, Westwood, on 12 or 14 Beckland Road has been deferred at the request of the officers for re-notification of a revised scheme. So that one's withdrawn. Agenda items 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. Councillor Gray has withdrawn her objection to those matters. So we can just resolve to send those items back to officers to be determined under delegated powers. Is that agreed?
Yeah, okay.
I've been notified of a matter of urgent business which I'll take after agenda items 3 and 5, which deal with future decisions under delegation. For now though, I do want to just move to agenda item 3. There is a privacy in attendance, but the report is comprehensive. It doesn't attract objections, and it's before because it is a development of over 50 units. In that case, we normally formally agree those type of applications. I'll move approval from the chair. Is there any?
There's a second round, chair.
Moving to agenda item 5, so again is it before us because it is an application of over 50 units. It is a reserved matters application following the grant of outline plan permission. Again, there's no substantive objections before us because it's a major application. Again, from the chair, I'll move approval of that application.
Well, I think, Chair, obviously before we second it, I think there's a general comment to make. Rather than simply passing these through. This site has attracted interest over a number of years, and you know, from a personal point of view, I would love it to be occupied by an extension of Burton's industrial use, employing lots and lots of people. But the site has remained empty for a period of time, and we also have the added pressure that we wish to protect other areas of Borough in our forthcoming deliberation under the local plan. And the previous application and this application are huge contributions towards those figures that we are all feel severely under pressure for. So to simply just pass it on the nod, I think it's a scheme that's been worked over a period of time, overcome a number of hurdles, and finally has come to fruition and will make a valuable contribution. But before, if you wish me to second it, I'll second it as part of that contribution. Thank you, Jay.
Thanks for that. Any further contributions or maybe votes? Okay, there's a favour of that application, I'm pretty sure. I'll interrupt our deliberations then to move to the report that's I've accepted as an urgent business. Of course, the Director of Regeneration had place to make some recommendations to us on how we should how we can potentially go forward in these strange times where meeting is not advised in the coming weeks. I've segregated it to the members that are new attending today for their discussion. There are should I wait? Would you like to speak to me?
Yeah, I think
okay, yeah. The bulk of it obviously is given on page one in terms of the decisions that the Director of Law is asking of us. I'll ask the Director to speak to their report and then I'll open it for debate. Members.
This is the urgent report. The position is, as stated in the urgent report, that there is as indicated, that the majority of decisions are dealt with by officers. As listed within the report, there are a number of criteria whereby, as your members are aware, those matters are brought before planning committee to determine. Now we are in strange times, worrying times at the moment, and really. To continue having committees until such time as the situation gets under control. In those circumstances, the government is publishing emergency legislation. There may be provision at some point, hopefully soon, to enable virtual meetings to take place. But at the moment, we have to work with the current legislation. As of today, there is no provision for that to take place. There is the provision that there are homeowners and developers who wish to, notwithstanding the current situation, proceed with planning applications. Some of those may have a criteria whereby they have to be determined by normally by planning committee. My recommendations within the report provide for the director to make that decision in consultation with the chair and the spokespersons. So I would suggest that there are clear criteria, clear ground to do that, but I'd certainly be interested in hearing from members. In this internal members' debate, clearly it's a matter for members now. Just to forestall any questions from members, ultimately the decision by members, the decision is ultimately, would ultimately be for the officer in consultation with the members. The officer would not be bound by the consultation responses, but would clearly have to pay close regard to those. But ultimately, proper location means it is ultimately the officer's decision. So there's no getting around that. That may be consent members, but that is the best fix that officers can recommend at this point.
Questions and then I have to get to yes.
We are in extraordinary times and by the day we find that the consequences of what's going on worldwide and we are not immune to that in any way, shape or form. And however, there are inherent things within the report that I think go against the grain for anyone who believes in democracy and democracy being seen to be done. So I'm glad that the recommendation includes consultation with party spokesperson. Something I've been harping on about this year, I do think it is necessary for officers to talk to the spokespersons prior to meetings, and they fell by the wayside this year for a whole host of reasons in terms of time and of when and how and officer availability. So I'm happy that that intrinsic sort of touchstone is there. But you said yourself, you know, it is only a touchstone and ultimately the officers make the decision. My preference, and whether it can find favour, is that where there is considerable local concern, and these applications, you know, we've been on the planning committee for many years, sometimes an extension at number 3 Acacia Avenue can be quite controversial to lots of people, and moving through to sometimes get massive applications that don't raise a whisper in the community in terms of objections and so on. So no one application is ever the same and cannot be treated the same. So my view would be that where the line says in consultation with party spokesperson, that is a mechanism for the wider political groups, and planning isn't political, but we do represent our communities as elected representatives. We would be acting as a sort of feed-in for local concerns, issues, petitions, and what have you. If it was possible, and we all know that this crisis is over sooner than we are being led to believe, but if that was possible, then those controversial items, if there was no consequential financial implications for the borough, and you know, maybe job development, and on the other side, no financial implications for the developer, where we would be seen to be in jeopardy of costs, that those items perhaps for that period of time could be fair and brought back at a later date. However, not every application is going to fall into that little neat little slot. So where there is concern, I would ask officers to work with government and ask that the government allow some form of virtual debate if meetings of this case are banned by law. I'm not sure whether they are banned by law, because Parliament's meeting. So they're not banned by their own law. If there's some mechanism where we can bring those controversial or issues of public concern to a public forum where people can safely contribute to the debate, then I would want something in the recommendation along those lines, because it's simply not right to hand over delegation. I believe, you know, full carte blanche delegation, yes, it's an emergency, but also there needs to be a microscope or a glass of democracy put over everything that we do, irrespective of the crisis that we're in. People demand that, you know, they see democracy happen and their thoughts and views put forward. Otherwise, you know, it would only make the situation worse, and I think that's what we do as a planning committee. And it's very rare that we have these ultimate decisions that can't be resolved one way or the other with a decision that is tested and defendable. So I just think would like to see some more guarantees if members are thinking like I'm thinking, some ways of either deferring these applications so we can go back to normality if that's possible, or having some mechanism through you know, teams and things like that have been mentioned. I had a meeting today with 14 colleagues from New Lever, and we managed to discuss the issue. I know there's a technical reason that you have to be there, you're sitting in the seat to cast your vote, but in the interim, I believe that there should be some way. If that's the case, then we would have to defer. And I want the message to go out as well that we in this planning committee are doing everything we can to be seen as a borough where people and big developers want to invest. And we want to find a mechanism that is quickest, but gives surety to the public as well. That's our goal. So I'm just opening that as a sort of plea that I think that first line is okay. It's a test. We are being consulted. But ultimately, where we may disagree with the officer that this is controversial or not, we need the the microscope of democracy on certain decisions at the moment. So I'm guaranteed that that might happen.
I'll just bring you to raise the issue of the bench. So as far as I'm aware, and I'll ask you to touch upon, our decision making processes are governed by 1974 legislation, which might not. Which might not be entirely up to date as far as modern technology is concerned. And there are two methods of delegation, one is to members meeting in public and one is to officers. But I'll let Lewis deal with the legal arguments on that.
Thank you, Chairman. The position is that with the Women Act 1992 and the legislation as follows, there is no provision for virtual meetings. As the law stands at the moment, we can't have members based on monitors saying aye or otherwise to proposals. So that's the basis on which this report's been taken forward. In terms of the councillor Foulkes' comments, the position is the planning committee itself could actually meet with four members. But again, it's not something that we would recommend to that big country, to all the messages that the government is sending out about not having public meetings like that, albeit with a small number of attendees. So having the forums that Councillor Foulkes mentioned again is problematic, because the fact is that if an officer has delegated authority, obviously subject to any consultation, there can't be any caveats on that. Ultimately, that officer has to have that ability to make that decision, otherwise it's not actually delegation. I can't find any other wording that would satisfy Councillor Foulkes' consent.
Thanks, Chair. Fully support.
Consider them all. 4, which is the which refers to applications which members have asked to be referred to planning committee. And appointment 5, which are applications that have attracted one or more petitions or objection to qualify as objecting. That's 25 signatures or more. They're the two matters that I would ask. In all seriousness, for developers who may have applications in, their applications have attracted opposition, their applications are not considered acceptable. People have an argument that they would wish to put to their democratic representatives and for us to determine that. Those people, in my view, are going to have to exercise patience on that. In terms of members asking for matters to be referred, I don't think members do it lightly. It just take up members' time when they do that. But nevertheless, I've asked members to exercise restraint on that. As for the other applications, major applications, applications involving members of staff, applications from other members, etc., etc., which haven't attracted any sort of widespread concern or triggered those matters in 4 or 5, I am comfortable to allow those to be decided under delegation. That at least will ease some of the workload. And in terms of major applications, and Steve made the point on the previous application, if we can get majors approved, then that will help us with the housing delivery test in due course. And again, I'm doubtful how much actual on-site work will be taking place during the period of the national emergency. That's my contribution. I'll ask for further contribution from Ian.
Thanks, I don't think we're in a position for long where we haven't got the powers to make a decision by online or whatever. The COVID bill apparently is being presented to Parliament today or tomorrow. It was recognised at the point on a conference call of the council, 300 council leaders with the Secretary of State on Tuesday morning that this has to be done. So I don't think it's going to be. I would imagine that the speed that bills are going through Parliament at the moment, I can't see it's not being in place by the time of our next meeting. It's in the diary anyway. So I don't see a problem with the points about the lines if we accept that clauses 4 and 5 of the recommendations are withdrawn, and then we as a committee make a decision whether it's online or so, we cross that bridge at the next meeting.
Restrictions lifted, or you've gone online, no voting, no
says that that would be the case.
So. Yeah, and no, when I say meet, it could be for any restrictions of the or where the riders, no, where not the losses and meets, not participating. Say we are against This is controversial. We feel there's long, bigger implications to this. We would like it to be, you know, have some public hearing. That's the sort of decision we would be making at the briefing. So, if there's not any major objections to the wording that we've used, I'd happy, be happy to second that. As I say, it could change tomorrow, let's be honest. So, I'm happy to second that, let's see.
Okay, are we content to move to a vote on that? See those in favour of that? Thank you.